We got this weird freaking mic. Is that so we don't need to use those stupid headphones anymore?
Yeah, that's those mic. Yeah.
That is so cool. Hello, can you guys hear us?
The issue is that we don't have stream audio. But,
okay. Who cares? But does the VOD have audio?
Yeah.
Alright, so who gives a shit?
Yeah, also this is my setup I came up with. Like,
oh no, that means we won't be able to hear like the valedictorian elegy when you're playing.
No! Valedictorian elegy.
The valedictorian elegy. Yeah. Alright, wait, is he... What's going on here? Who's the...
Okay, so...
we got Moog versus Uwu. Fox, oh, that makes sense.
I think a green Mega Man is enough selling by this point, but...
Oh, but look at that. FoxyGirl's actually kind of holding his own.
Alright,
nice. Oh, is Pool B starting?
Yeah, it just started, okay. Yeah.
Am I able to commentate this? I'll be quick. Alright. Anyways, so we got Moog versus FoxyGirl. I don't know if I've seen this matchup before. It probably happened already.
I think
Moog probably won.
Once,
right?
Maybe, but obviously.
But Foxy's been improving a lot, I feel. I feel like he could definitely pop off and get a bunch of top eights if he like locks in.
This turn-up specifically, I feel like a lot of like...
Can you go to the chat? Let's see if people are talking.
Yeah,
there.
Great.
Yeah.
I feel this tournament specifically. Oh, nice counter. That's cool.
Yep, that is
I feel
cool.
This tournament specifically is right around where rivals do release, and a lot of the, like, including me, a lot of the different players have different, like, rivals do habits. So it's
you think that's like the skills transfer? Like, if you grind rivals, you'll be better at Smash?
Yes.
Really?
But the thing is, you have to differentiate what games in your mind. Because I played a couple of friendlies.
Oh,
before
like
this.
Mess you up.
Yeah, it really does mess you up. Like, someone grabs you and you don't mess, you just press B once and you're confused, nothing happens.
What? Oh, it's like when you use different controls and you're like, what the hell? Like, accidentally. You know
no,
when you
no,
like.
No, it's a different mechanic completely.
Yeah. I'm like on the fence about it. On one hand, like, I already have enough games to play. I feel like Smash is kind of like the only fighting game I need. On the other hand, people are really liking it.
I immediately knew that, like months ago, that this will be the first fight, like, other game that Smash that I will enjoy.
I mean, you ever played Nick All-Stars 2?
No.
I hear it's good.
No, I heard it's bad.
Really? I mean, Nick All-Stars 1 was kind of bare bones, but, like, they improved it a lot for the second.
Yeah, but it's still bad.
Really?
Yeah.
But relax, made a video about it, and sure, it was probably sponsored.
Yeah,
but...
people played it for a week. I feel like that's
hey, at
the
least
difference.
It's better than Multiverses by, like, a lot.
Yeah. Listen, when Multiverses, like, reveal trailer, I had a lot of hope. Like, they had a good art style, maybe through, like, Smash 3.
I had so much, and it was actually, like, the beta was really good, and people liked it. I was about to fucking buy Maor's Xbox for it. I was, like, this close to just giving him,
that's
yeah, that's game one for Almog. But, honestly, like, Foxy kind of held his own for the most part there. I mean, he was down 2 stocks.
Yeah, so, yeah, it's about Multiverses. Yeah. When I saw the gameplay, even in the beta, I felt like, it's not that.
It's like meant for 2v2, that's the problem.
Yeah, but even in 2v2s, it felt a little weird. It didn't feel
people
good
say
much.
That the 2v2 experience is like a lot.
Yeah, but
that's just speaking of how bad the 1v1 experience is.
Yeah, and when I heard that they were spending a year to improve it, I had, this is good actually, because like, when it released, it was kind of weird.
Released so much worse.
Yes.
So much, and it was like pay to win, like, in the worst way possible.
Ma? Come in.
It, like, do you understand, like, you only have 3 characters, and you have to, like, grind to get a 4th, and everything else is locked behind, like, a $20 paywall. Like, what were they thinking when they made shit?
That's one thing I really like about Rivals, is that all their things... none of it will ever
like
be
you better. Buy the game and then the characters are all there, like,
yes.
Is that what it is? Oh, that's
yes.
That's exactly how it should be, like,
they're,
fuck anyone who tries to
their like business model is...
maybe like DLC, sure, like
no,
like,
all DLC will get free.
I mean, like, listen, if something's gonna have DLC like Smash, I'm not gonna complain, but like fucking Multiverses was just that's
yeah.
Just not
the thing about Rivals 2 is that they their business model is skins. They're doing custom skins.
That's amazing. That's just like Fortnite. That's how it
yeah,
should be.
And
yeah.
It was like custom picture animations, custom like effects.
S-tier
like
business model.
Custom voice acting.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
Do they ever have like guest characters?
They had in Rivals 1. I'm assuming they'll also be in Rivals 2 later down the line.
Who was the guest character?
I don't know.
Oh, a nice kill by Foxy.
In Rivals 1, they had Hollow Knight and Ori.
Hollow Knight.
Oh, sorry. Shovel Knight. Sorry, not Hollow Knight.
Shovel Knight.
Shovel Knight, yeah.
And I, like, know nothing about Rivals, but I'm gonna try to check out Shovel Knight.
I also avoided Rivals 1 because I kind of feel like Super Smash Bros. 2.
Like, it seems like Brawlhalla to me, you know?
No, not at all.
It's like the same type of thing in my brain.
No. Brawlhalla sucks.
I don't know if it sucks.
It sucks.
Okay. Sure. I guess it sucks then.
Okay, look at this actual lead from Foxy.
Yeah, Foxy's...
We kind of ignored this set.
No, we were just talking about
platform fighters.
Well, let's focus on this set now, because it's a little interesting. We have FoxyGirl is actually up nearly a stock. He's kind of holding his own here. That should be... Nope, that's out of percentage for death. Alright, he flips aside. He gets greedy with that forward smash and loses it. But he's still ahead, so let's see if he can hold on to this lead. And, I don't know.
Well, he kind of avoided that
game there.
It's really easy to get hit by
Mithra. Is annoying, okay?
As Junior.
No, but, like, I don't know what happened, but, like, Almog actually, like...
Ooh,
oh!
Nice downer. He's in stock lead, listen.
Yeah.
This is kind of insane.
Yeah, that's really good for him. That spike is literally what any Mega Man player would want.
Yeah, this
ever.
Is, every character I feel like has a with dream thing.
Yeah.
So for example, for Kazuya, he does like a combo, and then he like throws you up, and then he does like a double jump cancel upper.
Oh yeah.
That's
for Junior, it's got to be side B to up B hammer, like
yeah.
7D, right? Like that's.
For you, it's a side B to up B. For me, it's like upper further. That's how it works.
God, yeah, of course it is.
Mega Man is...
Wow,
no, actually,
that dash attack
actually,
Mega that's Man's, a crazy confirm.
Mega Man's, like, dry dream.
Come on, Foxy. I want to see Foxy win this just because of the comeback factor. Like, he's been improving a lot. I feel like this could be his time to shine.
Yeah, what I want to say is, like...
Alright, come on,
I don't,
that.
Nope. Actually, I don't think... oh, that was a weird edit by Almog.
Yeah, they're both kind of
yeah, kind
losing
of
it.
Spaghetti.
I mean, it's natural.
Mega
right?
Man's wet dream is actually like footstool in neutral B.
Alright,
like,
don't overextend here.
Footstool neutral B combos.
Wow.
Okay, let's see this
Foxy's
edge guard.
Got him at the edge there, but
ooh,
then he gets...
Oh! Wow!
Yes!
He's dead!
No!
What the fuck?
That's
no!
Bullshit,
that
man.
Was the clip-worthy moment.
Nah, you know what? I'm mad on Fox's behalf, but that's fucking... But like, sure.
Yeah,
whatever.
There was a lot of opportunity to live there, but regardless.
The fact that Pyro could just do that at like 20.
No,
that's not something she can just do.
That's
no?
Okay, I'm with Moggy on this one. This was insane by Moggy and bad play from Foxy. He could have saved.
No, you know what? That was good awareness by Moggy and good combo game.
Yeah.
But like,
that
I'm
was
just saying that's like
no, I also think
know?
That was a bad awareness by Foxy because he could have lived.
Could've teched that, right?
Not only could he tech that, he could have
DI'd
that
is
way
this,
better.
Best of five?
Yes.
Alright.
He could have DI'd that way better.
Yeah, yeah. He like died way too early. I mean, if he held like to the corner,
no,
he might have been
able to. I think he went straight up. He didn't DI that.
But there wasn't a kill screen, which makes it harder to DI, right?
No, kill screen makes it harder to get. If there's no kill screen, it's easier.
What? No? Because
yes.
Like you could input it if you see the kill screen, right? Like
no. If you see the kill screen and then input the DI, it doesn't DI.
I'm just gonna say, if I were Foxy, it would be, for me, like, whenever I lose in a frustrating way like that, it's hard to get
I would
back
know.
Moment.
I would know. I would know. I would know.
But, you know, let's see if, like, a trait of a good player is always kind of locking in, even when life sucks. So,
yeah, but I think he's maybe switched his mentality up. He, like, picks a different skin. I know that works for me.
Really?
Yeah.
I would never do that. I mean, I'm still waiting to pull back the Ludwig
you
on
know,
one fateful day.
Do you not know my Marios?
Of course, you have the neutral, you have the top hat, sometimes America.
No.
Sometimes.
I pick my skins based on how I'm feeling right before. So if I want to go...
Is it like a mood test?
Yes.
Really?
So my red Mario is not my default, it's a Go-Go Mario aggressive mesh. Black Mario is my classic. It's more neutral.
I like.
And my white Mario is when I want to get combos. So if I'm missing a lot of combos, I'm gonna.
What would you take to like reds? Like if it was like your last set ever.
White.
Yeah. I think the white one is the coolest one. Like they should have. You know what I think that Smash should have? Back to like the purchasable skins. They should have skins as cool as Mario Wedding that you could like buy for like $3. Or something, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Like
but...
imagine if they had Dry Bowser for $3, like that with unique voice lines and shit. Like they need to do that.
I think
Funky Kong.
This is a potential cool idea.
Oh,
but
very nice.
I think it breaks down really quickly when you get to third parties. Because imagine like Mario having 50 different skins and Cloud having.
You
zero.
Know what? I'll take it. It's just like with the music. Before Sephiroth, there were two Final Fantasy songs, and that's fine. You know, like, I mean, it's annoying, but like, I'll take the many Mario songs. even if that means Cloud gets shafted. Which, by the way, Sephiroth saved the music.
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah, he did completely. Oh wow. So actually, FoxyGirl kind of taking control of the stock.
Yeah, I thought he had one more stock, but no.
No.
Wow, that was a Yaga moment.
That was kind of Yaga.
No shield though.
Let's see here. Good for Foxy for, like, you know, not letting this be a shutout. Because even if he loses this game, you could say he's definitely, like, putting up a fight.
He has put up a lot of fight.
Yeah, right? Even the game one where he lost by two stops, he like, had an early death. Which kind of,
that was a great recovery round.
Yeah, very good. Going near the corner to go into the dead zone in Mega Man. You know, you can never count out Pyra and her freaking giant sword thing. Ooh, okay, get up to back and do it. I like the jab to disable the side before it happens. That's good by Foxy.
That was good shield.
Alright, you got it. Ooh! Honestly, that was
dying,
bad for Foxy.
Dying off the top, like,
no, like, he should have jumped. Yeah, when Pyra does that, you gotta get out of the way.
We don't have a camera, but I saw him trying to, like, jump from his chair. We're definitely not happy
about
that.
No, you just gotta get out of there and, like, reclaim neutral. You know, don't go swinging against Pyra when she's below you. That's lesson number zero. One. Lesson number zero. Alright, so Almog is kind of taking this game back. Pretty tragic.
Oh, wow.
Stock loss.
I think that should have been a short hop.
He's gonna go for a spin.
Wow!
Alright. GG's. Good showing by both players. Almog kind of getting those kills.
Yeah, definitely. Okay, yeah. I'm running to my.
I have a set. Yes, sir. Alright. Did anyone like text?
Stop set.
Yeah. Alright. Great.